Village Square Mall histories began in 1971 when a local celebrity named Gene Mayhood decided he wanted to build a mall for his little town of Effingham, having a population of just over 11,200 people. Usually, a town would at least build a mall at 16,000 people. Gene Mayhood, known for his later work, knew what he was doing, making the mall look as 70s as possible. Wooden planter boxes, these lamppost-looking things that look like they should be at Crossroads Mall in Fort Dodge, Iowa. Wooden benches, wooden storefronts, and last, but certainly not least, the really boring floors. Be finished in late 1971, opening with the mall's first and OG anchor at GC Murphy's. GC Murphy's was a five and dime or a variety store, and in early 1972, a Spurgeon's would open, and also a little later after that, an Eisner's Food Market would open as a shadow anchor. The mall would open with such stores as Playtime Arcade, Radio Shack, Bath & Body Works, Deb, Zales, Kirkland's Hallmark, Dollar General, and Brown's Drug, and many others. The mall would thrive in the mid-70s. Sometime around that time, Stage Department Stores would buy out Spurgeon's store in the mall and would make it a Stage store. Big changes were on the horizon for the mall and for... Wait, a theme park? Anyway, I'll be back soon. In 1976, an adjacent building would be added. Surely Gene Mayhood didn't have anything up his sleeve. Let me just read the script. A two-story amusement park, the biggest at the time for the United States of America, the whole country at the time. Anyway, I'm just gonna keep reading on. It had a roller rink, normal, a second story, also normal, a country club, yeah, they have that, 80s arcade games, bumper boats, yeah, it's pretty normal. They even had a full-sized Ferris wheel, and many, many other things. Wow, just wow. What a kind military veteran. In 1977, Gene decided he would spend more of his money and buy a plot of land right next to the mall and expand the mall. He managed to sign on a JCPenney anchor store to the mall and expanded the mall, adding 14 new specialty shops, bringing the mall up to how it looks today. In 1977, a cinema would open at the mall, and over the years, the mall had no major renovations, besides them gutting some stuff like the old roof that I miss, those lamppost-looking things, and the other things, maybe you can spot them. As the 70s and the early 80s began, more 80s-type tenants were moving in, like a disc jockey, Maurice's and Claire's, and more. The mall's thriving. Sometime around the late 70s, early 80s, C.G. Murphy would close and a Rule King would open. But in 1985, C.G. Murphy would be bought out by Ames, which means that a C.G. Murphy, if it stayed until 1985, it could have been at Ames, which would be really cool for a guy that has never seen an Ames, IRL. And I live in St. Louis, and Ames is a New England brand, so that would probably never happen. aesthetics of the early 70s weren't appealing as many more. Gene Mayhood didn't have the funds to renovate. Lincolnland would close at the mall, and which it would kind of stagnate. In the early 2000s, Jay Herzog and son would buy the mall from Gene Mayhood. As the 2000s began, many tenants of the past were leaving, like the Disc Jockey, which was just added in the early 80s, Radio Shack, Claire's, Deb, and more. They hit a turning point around the time when the Rule King closed in the 2000s-ish. Then the mall died, and it died fast. And the recession did not help. In 2008, the owner, Herzog and Son, defaulted on their loan, meaning it was back on the market. And maybe the worst possible owner himself, like, would appear. And we're gonna find out, like, in maybe a little bit. So, yeah, have fun. Sadly, in 2009, the slumlord himself, Mike Cohan, would find his next mall victim in Village Square Mall. He would not help the mall out at all. Into the 2010s, more stores would close, like CJ Banks, Glick's, Zales, Hallmark, and GMC, Maurice's, and even a Dollar General closed. Keep in mind, DG started to open stores in the middle of flippin' nowhere at this time. The mall would start to dip below 50% occupancy, and some other stores like Shoe Sensation and Stage had also closed by this time. In 2018, big news was coming for the mall. This next big impact is not really known. It either happened in 2017, like one of the sites say, or it could have closed in 2019 as deadmalls.com states. But in between that time, I'm just gonna say 2018 because that's in the middle of the road. The JCPenney anchor had been in a worse for wear condition. JCPenney had no plans of leaving the mall at this time. But the city said that the building was falling apart, which in turn it was, and that they needed to fix it. They were planning to fix it until they saw the reports of the sales. The sales had a major dip, like major dip, and so did the whole company, in fact. So JCPenney decided it was not worth it and shuttered their anchor for good, which made the mall anchorless entering 2020. In the mall in 2020. Physical retail in 2020. Safe to say that the mall was below 20% occupancy. And at that time, the mall was no longer profitable. Oh dang, Cohan dumped it. Wonder who's gonna buy it now. Kumar? Who's Kumar? The mall was making a genuine try to fix the mall. So good for them, which Kumar and development would be doing that. In 2021, the stadium cinema, which you actually probably forgot about, would expand and take over the former back entrance to the mall, is now just that ugly drywall mess. Also in 2022, a boating place, like a some kind of boat place, opened up in partially chunk of the former Rule King. And that kind of brings up to today. store opened in the former disc jockey, and they turned the neons on, and that's kind of where we are today. Like I just said, it's crazy how the mall hasn't seen a major renovation in its 53 years of being open, like at all. So, anyway, do you think Kumar will succeed? Do you think they'll fix the mall, or do you think the mall's doomed? As the population states, it's actually, I'm not even gonna look at something. I'm just gonna give a wild guess that it's below 16,000 people. So, yeah, Kumar can try, and I hope it does work. I would love to go back there and it be more alive than it was. But anyway, I guess I'll see you in the next video.